would like to give the floor to Anna van Dijk. She's an associate professor at the University of Antwerp, and she will tell us something, I think, about the Belgian security. The floor is yours.
First of all, thank you very much for the invitation. In my talk today, I will focus on the role of the national judges in the recovery procedure, and I will more specifically look at how recovery legislation can help national judges in overcoming certain challenges and difficulties. So, in fact, I want to take care of the judges today. And so to do that, I will compare the Dutch recovery legislation that was just discussed by my colleague and the Belgian legislation that we have in place. So first, I will also give some statistics of Belgian state aid recovery cases. Then I will briefly summarize the role of the national judges from a new perspective in recovery cases. Then I will explain my case, the excess profits ruling, the Belgian state aid case. And then I will look at how, for instance, the Belgian state aid case, the Belgian excess profits ruling state aid decision, will be dealt or is dealt with in Belgium, and how this would be dealt with in the Netherlands, and what legislation is the most appropriate to help national judges fulfill their role. So first, some statistics. As in the Netherlands, you can see on the slide that the state aid cases are rather limited. Since 2000, we had 13 state aid cases, and now, since 2014, there are still five cases pending. One of them is the excess profit ruling decision. The cases are limited, but on the other hand, the amounts at stake are very high, and they have a very invasive effect on the beneficiaries. You see that until 2013, 333 million euros was considered as state aid, and the major part of that amount has been recovered in Belgium. You can also see that the amounts are higher than the amounts that have been considered as state aid so far in the Netherlands. But then in the new cases, the amounts are even higher. You see the excess profit ruling decision, there we are talking of already about 700 million euros. These are the decisions at EU level. When we look at court decisions regarding state aid, you can also see that the court decisions so far of Belgian courts are limited. Since the year 2000, I could find 76 court decisions. And the tax cases, so tax courts decisions in relation to state aid, are even more limited. There are only three cases, and these three cases, in fact, are decisions of our Belgian Constitutional Court, where a taxpayer claimed that a certain tax or the scope of application of a certain exemption was not in line with the principle of equality, our constitutional principle of equality, because the tax or the exemption was selective. And so then at the same time, the taxpayer invoked that there was not only an infringement of the constitutional principle of equality, but also of the state aid rules. And that was the argument of the taxpayer. Unfortunately, in these cases, the claim was not successful, so the Constitutional Court ruled that there was, in fact, there was no problem. What are the recovery methods that we know in Belgium? Contrary to what is the case now in the Netherlands, we do not have a general recovery legislation, but in principle, the ordinary rules apply. So this means that ordinary administrative law or ordinary civil law procedures are applicable. And the question which procedure is applicable depends on the nature of the measure in through which the aid was granted. In addition, our legislator introduced specific ad hoc legislation at two occasions. So after the Commission decision, at two occasions, the legislator introduced a specific law to organize the recovery of the state aid as ordered in the Commission decision. The first time was a long time ago in my Bell case, concerned exemptions of social security contributions, which were considered as state aid, and then now more recently the excess profit ruling, which is also considered as a state aid scheme, and so recovery was necessary, and so the recovery is organized in a specific legislation, and it is this specific legislation that I would like to compare with the Dutch legislation as is recently introduced in the Netherlands. If we look at these recovery methods, what is the role of the national judges? What is the task? What is the role of the national judges? Well, in the role of the national judges, in the first place, is very challenging. The national judges have to find a balance between, on the one hand, their national law, and on the other hand, the EU law. We all know that in principle there is national procedural autonomy, but on the other hand, the judge also has to take care of an immediate and effective recovery. And so the national court has to leave national procedural rules that may hinder that effective and immediate recovery. They have to leave it unapplicable. For instance, suspension rules or limitation periods. On the other hand, the task of the national judge is also very complex. We know that the Commission itself must not determine the individual amounts to be recovered. In general, the tax administration will do so, but it is the task of the national judge, when there are certain discussions about the amounts, to review the calculation of the amounts. And our experience in Belgium is that that is not always easy. For instance, in the Maribel case I just mentioned, concerned exemption of social security contributions, but that case concerned more than 2,000 enterprises, and in order to determine the amount to be recovered, one had to look at every quarter how many manual workers were employed by a certain enterprise and how many hours that worker was actually employed and worked, in order to be able to compute the exemption that was lawfully granted. So that was a huge work, and it's really complex then for a judge to be able to review that calculation. So a very complex task for the judges, but also a very important task, because based on the decisions of the Court of Justice, if the effective and immediate recovery is not possible or is not realized as a result of a court, of a national court decision, then also a state can be sanctioned for failure to implement the commission decision. And so very important task there also for the national judges. And then finally, it is also the role and the task of the national courts to take care of the fundamental rights of the beneficiaries. For instance, legitimate expectations. The beneficiaries count on the national judges. But on the other hand, we also know that in state case decisions, national judges have to put aside their national principles, for instance, the national legitimate expectation principle, and apply the very strict EU principle of legitimate expectations. I think that for some beneficiaries, that's churches may leave beneficiaries with kind of an awkward feeling. And I think also here, this requirement may raise certain questions about the legitimacy of EU state aid rules, the legitimacy of a recovery of state aid rules, and that makes it even more difficult for a judge to make or to take such an invasive recovery decision. So if we take all these considerations together, I think we can say that the judge, the national judge, is faced with some tensions that he has to solve. On the one hand, he has a very important role. He has to review the state aid cases. But on the other hand, the state aid cases are very complex. And we have seen that national judges only have to deal with a limited number of cases. So they don't really have the opportunity to become experts in these matters. And so maybe it's difficult for a judge to fulfill this important role. Second, the judge also has to manage the balance between EU law and national law, which is not easy. And then finally, the recovery of state aid may be very invasive, as I mentioned, because of the high amounts that are at stake. And on the other hand, the national court has to base its, to ground his decision on EU state aid rules that maybe lack a little bit of legitimacy, which is a delicate decision. So what I want to do in the remaining part of my talk is to look at to what extent does the Dutch legislation, or to what extent does the Belgian legislation help the national judges to overcome all these difficulties and all these challenges. And I will use for this comparison a case, the excess profit ruling case. I'm a Belgian tax specialist, so I do the Belgian case. The excess profit ruling was extensively promoted by our Minister of Finance. And what was the idea of the excess profit ruling? Well, the idea was that if you have a company in Belgium, part of a multinational group, then a part of the profits, of the accounting profits of that Belgian company would not have been realized by the Belgian company if that were a standalone company. And why? Because part of those profits, in fact, are generated by group synergies, are generated by intangibles. So this part of the profit should not have been allocated from a tax perspective, from an arm's length perspective, to that Belgian company, but in fact belongs somewhere to the group. So the idea was we are going to exempt that profit. And how is this realized? Well, Belgian law provided a downward profit adjustment equal to that profit generated by the group synergies. Of course, one of the ideas behind this rule was also to transfer activities to Belgium, because in that case, part of your profit would remain tax exempt. One of the arguments also to introduce this downward profit adjustment was the fact that there may be a risk of double taxation, because to the extent that this profit allocated to the Belgian company is generated by group synergies, there is always a risk that part of that profit will also be taxed abroad into another and added to the profits of another company. And so that was one of the considerations, but the law does not provide that it is really required that that part of the profit is effectively picked up in another country. And so the possibility that it might be taxed abroad is sufficient. The commission started an investigation in February 2015, and then in 2016 there was the decision that the excess profit rulings consisted or were qualified as an illegal state-aid scheme, and so really, really a scheme. There were about 66 rulings granted, and in January 2016, so we had the commission decision. The Belgian state tried to obtain a suspension of recovery, but this was dismissed. And in December 2015, we were aware of the fact that in January the decision of the commission would come. So the legislator introduced a specific recovery legislation for the excess profit ruling scheme. Meanwhile, the Belgian state and then also a lot of corporations introduced a claim with the general court. But meanwhile, I think most of the amounts are recovered so far. So this is the case, and what I would like to do now is compare. How does the Belgian excess profit ruling recovery legislation works, and how does this compare to the Dutch legislation, and which one is the better? So if we compare both legislations, there is one very important similarity. The aim of the Belgian legislator and also the aim of the Dutch legislator was to provide a legal basis for recovery. Based on a case law of the Court of Justice, the Commission decision as such cannot be enforced against the beneficiaries. It's not an enforceable instrument. Why? Well, because you need an individual decision in which, for instance, the individual amount to be recovered is calculated. And this is not the case in the commission decision. And in tax matters, most of the times, this individual decision will be an individual assessment by the tax authorities. And so I think that it's a very good thing, a very good thing that we have a law, a national legal basis for the national tax authorities to take that decision. So that's an important similarity. The same, there was the same consideration of the Belgian and the Dutch legislature. What is an important difference, however, is that the Dutch legislature has chosen to introduce a general recovery legislation for all future commission decisions. We don't know which decisions will occur, but one general legislation ex ante, so before all the commission decisions that may still be issued. In Belgium, on the contrary, the legislator has not introduced such general legislation, but has chosen to introduce specific legislation, especially for those commission decisions where there are a lot of beneficiaries involved. The Maribel case and now the excess profit case. As I will try to show a little bit further in my presentation, I think this offers the opportunity, the possibility to make tailor-made rules and to address specific problems that can occur in these recovery cases. So first, I will briefly touch upon two general differences between these two legislations, and then I will discuss two more specific differences that relate to this narrow scope of the Belgian recovery legislation. So first, a general difference concerns the qualification of the aid to be recovered. I understand that in the Netherlands, in the Dutch recovery legislation, the tax aid to be recovered is qualified as a tax. In Belgium, we had some discussions about the qualification of tax aid to be recovered, and there were some considerations. The first consideration was that we are state aid specialists. If you recover state aid, the amount to be recovered does not have the nature of the measure to which the aid was given. Aid recovered has a sui generis nature. So that was one consideration. And then the second consideration was the question, if this aid to be recovered is qualified as a tax, maybe we can have the problem that this is considered as a retroactive tax that is introduced now, but in fact concerned quite some years ago, and a retroactive tax would be contrary to our principle of legal certainty. So in Belgium, the amount to be recovered in principle qualifies as a sui generis amount, but then for the application of certain rules, it is qualified as a tax. For instance, it is qualified as a tax in order to make sure that it is considered as a non-deductible tax expense, because otherwise you would again have a benefit. The rules concerning the establishment and collection of taxes are also explicitly applicable. So here there is a similarity with the Netherlands. For recovery of tax aid, we also apply the rules, the procedure for establishment also, the tax is the amount to be recovered is assimilated to a tax for the application of international instruments on mutual assistance for recovery, and also for the legal remedies. So, if you have an assessment of the tax authorities in order for the tax to be recovered, then the normal legal remedies, the administrative procedure. Will be applicable. There was one discussion that we also discussed during the previous sessions of this project, which judge is competent. And we had here four Belgian tax judges. And the fact that the amount to be recovered is in principle not a tax amount raised the question, well, are we competent then? Because it's not really a tax. I think our analysis is that indeed the tax judges are competent because it concerns the calculation of a tax, so the application of the tax law. And most discussions will also arise after the assessment of the tax authorities. When the assessment of the tax authorities is challenged by the beneficiary, it will concern this tax assessment. And so that brings us to the tax judges. A second general difference concerns the situation when the commission decision is successfully challenged. I understand that in the Netherlands, this situation is not addressed in the recovery legislation. In our excess profits ruling legislation, this situation is dealt with. So first, it is clarified that repayment to the beneficiary can only occur when there is a final decision, either a decision of the general court without possibility anymore for appeal, or a decision of the Court of Justice. It is also clarified then which procedure applies. So it's our relief ex officio. It's an existing procedure, and the tax authorities have to repay the amounts within a period of 12 months. And then a specific problem is also addressed, because if we would not have these specific rules, then the normal moratorium interests would be due to the beneficiary. But our moratorium interests are much higher than the EU interest, and so the beneficiary would receive too much back. And so here the moratorium interest is limited to the EU interest. Then just two more specific examples of how specific legislation makes it possible to make tailor-made rules. Because if you introduce general legislation, as is the case in the Netherlands, then there may be certain problems. There are certain problems that you may not think of on beforehand, and these problems have been addressed in this specific legislation. The first one is the beneficiaries. In the Commission decision, the Commission has mentioned that the beneficiary of the excess profit rulings are not only the Belgian companies, but also all the companies that are part of the multinational group. And then there was also a list with the Belgian companies that received a benefit based on this ruling. Based on this information, for a national judge, it may be difficult to know which companies are aimed at here. So the Belgian legislator first explicitly clarified that not only the companies on the list are aimed at, but also other companies. And second, it clarified that the additional assessment is, of course, in the hands of the Belgian company, but then...
Just need to get the charges.
But then the tax assessment is also enforceable against all other members of the group. And this situation is not really addressed in Dutch legislation. The second one is the amount to be recovered. In the Commission decision, the amount to be recovered seems calculation seems very straightforward. The amount to be recovered is the tax benefit received, increased by the interest calculated as from the date that you received the benefit. But this is not so easy, because in Belgium, for instance, the date when you receive the benefit is not clear. In Belgium, take for instance the year 2013, application of the excess profit ruling in 2013. For only profits of 2013. In Belgium, a company has to make prepayments every quarter. Every quarter you have to estimate what is my tax due for this quarter, and you have to pay that estimated that tax due. 2013. In 2014, you have to file your tax return, and then the year thereafter, you will receive your final assessment. And when was the benefit received? When you had to pay your prepayments, when you filed your tax return, or when you received the final assessment. If a judge has to interpret the Commission decision, there is no further guidance. So here the advantage of the law is that the Belgian legislator explicitly provided that the amount, that the benefit is considered to be received on the date of the fourth prepayment of corporate income tax. So in 2013, in my example. I will not discuss all these difficulties, but you see on the slide that there are a lot of concrete difficulties and technical problems with the calculation of the amount to be recovered. I will give a second and last example here, the application of other tax deductions. In practice, there were a lot of companies that were, in fact, entitled to other tax deductions. For instance, the patent income deduction, the notional interest deduction. But at that time, they did not claim those deductions into their tax return because they weren't paying any tax based on the excess profit ruling. So there was no need to claim all the other deductions. And so they did not fulfill the formalities that you need to comply with in order to get the deduction. And so then the question was, can we apply those deductions now to calculate the amount to be recovered? Because the formalities have not been complied with. And so there the legislator clarified, yes, you can do so, provided that you can prove now that at that time you complied with all the other conditions to get the taxes. So, the conclusion. What's the conclusion of my legislation, specific ad hoc legislation after the commission decision, can help the judge to fulfill his important role and can help the judge to deal with the complexity and to deal with the complexity of state aid rules. And because in the specific legislation, the legislator can give guidance to the judge how to compute that amount to be recovered. Second, I think in a specific legislation, the legislator can also give more guidance to the judge in respect of how the balance between conflicting EU law and national law should be addressed. For instance, in the excess profit ruling legislation, the legislator also clarified that to the extent that the excess profit is picked up in another country and is effectively taxed abroad, then this amount should not be considered as state aid anymore, and so there should not be recovery. That is something that was not very clear in the commission decision, and so here the legislator helps the administration, but also the national judge to deal with that. And then finally, and this conclusion is maybe a little more subtle, I think that specific recovery legislation may also help to contribute to the legitimacy of EU state aid rules. Why? Well, first, of course, there is a legal basis, a national legal basis. So the judge does not have to rely only on EU law, but can also rely on what his national legislator decided. But second, I think that a specific recovery legislation also offers the opportunity for introspection. What do I mean when you have specific recovery legislation on a specific state aid that has to be debated in parliament? There, the financial interests at stake are very high. And I think that offers the opportunity to question oneself. And what have we done? We have introduced the state aid and now we have to recover it. Was it really our intention to introduce a selective tax incentive where all members of parliament fully aware of the fact that that selective measure was introduced? Did we really let pressure groups push this selective measure through parliament? How could that happen? What happened? And so I think that all these considerations may also help a national judge to find more legitimacy in the EU state aid rules and in the recovery, and so that also helped the judge to take his very invasive decision. Thank you.